All right, so moving on, let's get started with the assembly of the grip section of the blaster. So first thing here is the selector switch, and what I've done is it basically goes into this little well here, and by itself it just sits in there. It's a nice flush fit, but there's really nothing holding this in place. So what I'm going to end up doing is putting a dab of E6000 on right there, and then also right there just to hold it in place. I went ahead and marked a couple of dots there that'll represent kind of a marking location for that leftmost contact. Then here, I know that this is in line with the actual switch, so when it gets installed, it'll go like that. And so I have this pointed in the middle position of the switch, so that'll be that R position. And what I ended up doing is I put a dot, a little red dot there, so I could get my alignment straight. So let's get some E6000 and get this secured. Okay, so that should about do it there. We'll let that sit up just a little bit. So then, how this all goes, the trigger guard goes there. So I'm just checking right now that this is still pointed towards that red dot, and it is. So that there goes together. Oops. So I put that screw there just to hold this whole assembly together while I got these bits put together, put in. But then now for this plate, I'm gonna unscrew this and put the plate on. So the switch has these two holes there, and that screw will hold the switch in there. So I have to make sure I get it to the right orientation here. So I'm using the toothpick to locate one of the holes so I could get the other one aligned. Should have gone through. So the switch is installed. And let's move this back in place. Put the trigger pin back in. There we go. See what else. This plate goes on the outside. This screw here. That's nice and tight. So this piece goes on the very bottom of the grip itself. I'm not sure if it matters what direction. Looks like it's down in there. Should just drop in. Make sure that there's no interference. There we go. So this is a 3/16 inch hex wrench. Let's see if we get this. Yep, nice and tight. You can see through there. So this bolt is next. So when I got the kit, I tore everything down, and this actually came pre-assembled from Blaster Factory or War Machines, either or. But I stripped it all down, cleaned it with some soap and water. Okay, and I think that'll do it for now. So these screws will hold the grip to the barrel. So I will tackle that at a later stage. Next up is the replica stock from Field Marshal. So let's get started. So for this, you will need an 8/32 Allen key, and it should be pretty straightforward. So let's get started. So these two pieces will go together. You'll end up lining up the holes there. So that'll sit there for now. This spring goes in the middle. Make sure on this piece here, the pointy side faces the rear. Press this in. And for this catch, this is actually what holds the stock when it's folded to the front of the barrel. So this will just slide in here, but make sure that hook points towards this end. See there. There it goes. And what I would suggest that you start the threads on both ends. And with all of my parts, I stripped down everything, cleaned it with some soapy water, and then so I got all the grease and dirt that normally comes with these machined cast parts, and then greased all of the threads so that it's nice and clean. There's no metal shavings or burrs. So, in this little guy here, this is kind of the tricky part, but you gotta push. Should be able to see where those threads are, so I'll advance it. Until I see it just start to protrude. Do it on the other side as well. In There we go. There you have it there, and let's see if I can get this on camera. Let you unfold it like this. There you have it. And then what I also ended up doing here was there were some cast marks. So I filed those down on the top here. Nope, didn't touch that. I did it on the inside here as well, smoothed it out as much as possible on both ends, and then there were some lines, some seam lines around both of these contact points there. And I also took a file inside those holes just to smooth things out. And then that's pretty much it. All right, that is an assembled replica Field Marshal stock. All right, next up is the mag well for the E11. So in this case, you will need a 5/32 hex key for this bolt. And this is what attaches the magwell to the barrel of the E11. So that part I'll save until later for the assembly piece. But to assemble the magwell, you won't need this, so I'll set that aside. But you do need a 1/8 hex key for that particular bolt there. So let's follow along. What you might have seen here is I did shave off some of the cast nubs there. Not sure if I could see that or not. There is a little bit of a ridge. I probably will take care of that later. But I did run a file all throughout the edges just to smooth it out as much as possible. Yeah, you can see there. I'll probably take that down a little bit later. But anyway, so let's get started. You have this piece. I'll insert through here this way. And this piece goes right in here. Note, when I got this, there was a lot of flashing and leftover material around the inside of that, as well as on this particular piece. Do yourself a favor, clean that up with some needle files. It makes things, during installation much easier. So this goes in there, and I'll take the spring, slide it over this screw, and then this goes inserted through here. Straightforward there, and you can see the end of that screw come right up there, right? So that's that, and this is all set. It's ready to be installed onto the blaster. All right, next up is the bolt for the E11. This one is pretty straightforward. Really no tools are required. So why don't we get started? Yeah. Have the spring. You have to insert it into that little hole at the bottom. There you go. And then this pin. Should drop in. And then just need to have some sort of apparatus to get it in there. Sometimes it can be a little finicky. There you go, so it's sitting right there. This slides right in here. Make sure that slides. And I don't know if you can see, but there it is. It doesn't take much to get those holes aligned. Let's get started. Go. All right, there you go. You have an assembled bolt.